fellows, we are here to talk about the second part of integral theorems. It's going to be quick and easy, just a little theory, a little formulas, and we are done. So good news to you and better news to me. So the next theory we are going to see is surface integrals. As its name says, it's an integral buried in a surface, and it's an extension of the double integral with this formula. Okay, this is the formula, and it works for all the surfaces in an object. Okay, you can use it for any kind of surface and as many surfaces as you want. Remember that C is the curve, S is our surface, and N is going to be the integral we are going to look. It could be in this surface or any other part of the object. Okay. The formula of the surface integrals works with the Gauss theorem. The Gauss theorem says that this formula is going to, first of all, used by this other sign, hold on, okay. This sign is used for the double integrals. It's just to save this the time of doing both integrals, and it's calculated with the gradient. Remember that the gradient is just the partial derivatives. It's a dot product with the formula. And this is how you calculate the surface integrals. Actually, it's not that hard, you just have to derivate two times the integral. Sorry, no. You have to integrate twice the formula. I'm sorry. And that's how you're going to get our surface integrals, as we see it in the other theorem. In the Green theorem, how you calculate the double integrals. So this is all for the surface integrals. I'm going to go a little bit quickly, so let's go on to see the next theory. Are just the same as double integral, but with an extra integral. With this formula, where T means a region where we are going to work, and the divergence of the formula derivative against V, and this is going to be equal as our integral of a surface at the function the dot product of the surface divided with A. Okay. This is our formula. And it's work with this this function. Those are the values of our formula that we are going to use, and our aim is going to work with these values, sine of alpha, sine of beta, and the cosine of gamma. Okay, these are going to be replaced in the formula. Let me just no, I believe I can wait over there. Partial derivative of 2, partial derivative of 1, plus partial derivative of f3, partial derivative of c. Okay. These are how the formula is going to be work. Now we got this, and when we replace it for this formula, it's going to be just like this. I was forgetting the derivatives. Okay, this is the formula that we're going to work with, that are the same as this next formula. I need to erase this. So, this is how we get the triple integrals, and to get the inverse of the divergence, which is a point in our domain T, which is our perhaps is independent, okay? And it's given by the formula that I'm going to write after I erase some of these. The formula for the inference divergence. Given by the formula of divergence of the function of our point P when we have our limit when our domain T tends to 0 is 1 over V of T against our double integral is of T of a function dot product of n dA. Remember, double integrals work with this formula. And that's how we get our theorem of triple integral theorem. Next theorem is a continuation for the divergence theorem, our further applications. Divergence. The principal application for the divergence theorem is to solve harmonic equations and a solution for Laplace equations that go with this. This kind of equation is always going to, well, it's an harmonic equation, is always going to give us 0 as long as it repeats the property of harmonic functions that says that the difference of f1 minus f2 will give up 0, and this means that domain T are harmonic, is a harmonic function as long as we have a 0. Okay, hope it's going to be good if this was all, but we have to see a little of harmonic functions. What those harmonic functions say? Well, we have to assume that these variables are harmonic function With the domain D equal to 0. Remember, 0 means harmonic. And okay, this 0 is going to mean in all the surface D is equal to 0, and this is going to prove that or domain T, no, hold on. As long as our domain D is 0, our function is also going to be equal to 0 in any part of the surface. That makes the resume whole theorem of harmonic functions, and this helps us to solve unique Laplace equations. So unique Laplace equations with the Turing theorem, it says that F is uniquely determined by T, if, no, by its values. What does this mean? Well, it means that if we have our harmonic function in our domain D, that T is going to be have the boundaries of S. So again, S, our domain D is going to be equal to 0, and T is going to be all our surface. If F is a harmonic and it's valued in any point of S, then it means that, well, F will be determined by the value of T. Okay? Well, I think it's enough for the divergence theorem, and we're going to see now the Stokes theorem. So let F be a continuous vector function that exists in a domain that contains S or surface. It's explained by this function in a double integral. Where n is a unitary vector of S. So remember n is a Noetherian vector and f is a continuous vector function that we're going to have continuous partial derivatives, and all this is going to be equal to this equation, but I'm going to erase this, so just give it a couple of minutes. I know my board is not big enough, so I'm going to erase this and this, and let's go to start writing our equations. And all this is going to be equal to this resume formula. And in one, n is going to be, oh hold on, okay, well remember our last equation where we have n, our unitary normal vector, that is going to be given by the derivative of n with respect of u and of v, and or r prime going to be given by derivative of dx, dy, and DC. That's the Stark theorem. That's the formula. That the formula where how we can calculate it, and it's actually all our theorems we have to see in this two-part video. I hope you like it, and because I want my extra points. So that's all. See you later, folks. Probably in a couple of weeks for our next video. And I'm going to add a little more detail. It's going to draw a cupo. And that is all. So, see you.